Indeed, researchers around the world began to create autophagy-deficient cells or organisms in line with their interests and investigate the implications of autophagy disruption. Collectively, this work revealed that autophagy is involved in a really wide range of biological phenomena beyond anyone's expectations, and also demonstrated links to a number of diseases in humans. We will talk about this in further detail next week. Further progress resulting from the discovery of the ATG genes was the identification of a marker to label autophagosomes, which gave researchers an important tool in autophagy research. A protein named ATG8 in yeast, or LC3 in mammals, which is encoded by one of the ATG genes, was found to exist on forming and complete autophagosomal membranes. By expressing these proteins as a fusion protein with green fluorescent protein, which is usually called GFP, researchers were able to observe autophagy in living cells under a fluorescence microscope. As you can see in this movie of living mouse cells, shifting cells to starvation medium results in the formation of many puncta of GFP-LC3, representing autophagosomes. In this way, researchers could see the induction of autophagy in a much easier way, in real time and using living cells, which was a major improvement in fluorescence microscopy. Moreover, transgenic mice expressing GFP-LC3 were generated in the lab, which allowed us to know when, where, and how much autophagy is activated in a whole mouse body. The molecular mechanisms of autophagy have also been thoroughly studied by examining the ATG proteins. ATG proteins form several functional units, including complexes for protein modification and repeat modification, a membrane protein localized to a small vesicle, and protein conjugation systems. It was subsequently found that these proteins get together at the site for autophagosome formation and cooperatively act to form the autophagosome. In particular, recent studies greatly extended our understanding of how starvation signals are transmitted to particular ATG proteins to induce autophagy. This information about the mechanism of autophagy also provided us with an important basis for understanding the physiological function of autophagy in our cells. This graph showed the number of research papers published in the field of autophagy over the last 30 years, which is an indicator of research activity and general interest in the field of autophagy. As you can see, the discovery of autophagy in yeast, the identification of ATG genes, and subsequent elucidation of the basic mechanism of autophagy triggered the explosive growth of the autophagy research that continues today. This culminated in the award of the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine to Dr. Osumi in 2016. Before we finish this week's lecture, I'd like to add a couple of points about his achievements in the development of autophagy research. Dr. Osumi not only made pioneering discoveries using yeast, but also greatly contributed to the development of the autophagy field, allowing research to progress to the next stage. Based on the information obtained by analysis using yeast, he immediately initiated the study of autophagy in mammals and plants in his own lab. He also used a whole range of techniques, including genetic, morphological, molecular biological, and biochemical approaches, and initiated collaborative research with structural biologists to determine the structures of ATG proteins. This promoted a comprehensive understanding of the mechanisms and roles of autophagy. In this way, his group has produced an essential body of many outstanding results. And while the tremendous achievements of many other researchers around the world were important in the development of autophagy research, Dr. Osmi's group played the leading role in the field. Finally, I'd like to emphasize that Dr. Osmi never set out to receive the Nobel Prize or to directly find a cure for any particular disease when he began his research in autophagy. His study has always been driven by his pure curiosity and desire to learn about the basic function of cells.